So in the last video, we have discussed what variables in Python indicate and what are the naming convention that can be used for variables. And in this video, we'll see what constants and literals in Python mean. So what are constants and what are literals? So a constant in Python is a variable whose value cannot be altered. So consider this example, pi equal to 3.14, which indicates pi is a variable which stores a value 3.14 and cannot be altered. So max size is another constant whose value is fixed to 70. So max size is a constant which I want to indicate the class size in the student application, which indicates that my class size is restricted to 70 and cannot be altered during the program execution. So actually in Python there are no predefined constants like in other programming languages. Other programming languages like C, C++, they offer certain constants that are predefined, like pi, e, all these are predefined as constants. But in Python there are no predefined constants. Though they are available as variables, they can be varied in the due course, but you make sure that your code will not change the values that are assigned to the constants. So just to recognize the variables as constant, the naming convention that can be followed is you just use all the letters in the constants as uppercase. So thereby you can recognize them in your code. They are the constants and you better don't change them. Now let's try to understand what literals mean in Python. We have seen variables are the names that are given to the objects or the values in Python, and constants are also the names that are given to the values but whose values cannot be changed during the program execution. Whereas literals are the values that you are assigning to either variables or the constants. Don't get confused between constants and literals. So constants are the variables that cannot be changed, where literals are the values that you are assigning to the variables or constants. And Python provides a long list of literals like numeric type, string type, boolean type, even the special type of literals it provides in addition to the collection type of literals. So let's see each of them in detail. So Python provides various numeric literals. A number that can be assigned to any variable or constant directly is recognized as a numeric literal. And of course they are immutable, they cannot be changed during the program execution. So numeric literal types are again of different types. So integer, float and complex. They all come under the numeric literals. So integer literals are the numbers without any fractional part. So whenever you are considering any number without any fractional part, they are treated as integer literal in Python. They can include either positive numbers or the negative integers. And integer literals again can be represented in four different ways. So decimal numbers, that is decimal integers, where the variable can be directly assigned with the number. So if you observe the number that is directly assigned to the variable n, the value is 10 here. So in case of the binary, so you are assigning a binary value to the variable b. Here you can recognize the binary number by prepending the value with the symbol 0b. So whichever the value that is prepended with 0b, that number is treated as binary number in Python. Similarly, octal numbers, they are prepended with the symbols 0o. O stands for octal, b stands for binary. Whereas hexadecimal numbers, they are prepended with the symbols 0x. X stands for hexa. So whatever the number that is followed by the 0x, that is treated as hexadecimal literal. So a decimal number does not prepend with anything directly, they can be assigned, whereas a binary number is prepended by 0b, octal number with 0o, whereas a hexadecimal number is prepended with 0x. Now let's see how we can use floating point type literals in Python. So float literals are the real numbers which has two parts, integer and the fractional part. So like pi equal to 3.14. Here 3.14 is a value which is of float type that is assigned to the variable pi. So 3.14 constitutes two parts. 3 is the real part, whereas 14 is the fractional part. So consider CGPA of a student 7.6. 7 is an integer part, 0.6 is the fractional part. So they can even be the negative type, like -1.02. So that's how we can use floating type literals in Python. So now consider the complex type of literals. So complex literals have both real part and the imaginary part. So general form is a plus bj, where a indicates the real part and b indicates the imaginary part. So consider this example, 1 plus 2j, which is assigned to the variable x. So here 1 indicates the real part of the complex number, where 2 indicates the imaginary part of the complex number. So that is how we can have different types of numerical literals. So numerical literals are of type integers, complex numbers, and even the floating point type. So now let's see how string literals can be used in Python. Any sequence of characters enclosed in quotes are treated as string literals in Python, and you can use either single quote, double quote, or triple quote to enclose a string. And for example, you can consider Python is a string literal which is enclosed in double quotes, where hello world is a string literal which is enclosed in triple quote. A string literal can have capital case letters, small case letters, or the digits, or even the special symbols also. Any printable character can be part of your string literal. Here RMU stands for roll number of the student, and to which you are assigning the string literal 191A FA04001. So that's how we can create strings by enclosing them in double quotes, triple quotes, or even the single quotes also. Now consider the grade, which is literal with single character. Remember, in other languages we have string and character, but in Python even a single character is also treated as string only. There is no special type like character. So Python allows us to use different types of quotes to enclose strings, but to whatever the quotes you are using to open, so the same quotes must be used to close the string literal. So strings can be of single line strings, or they can even be of multiple line strings. So let's see how we can use the single line strings. So you can create a single line string like S1 equal to hello world by enclosing them in the same line itself. You can use a multi-line string by enclosing the string in triple quotes, where the string is extended to multiple lines. Or even you can use the continuation character, that is slash symbol, to indicate that the string is extended to multiple lines. That's how we can use strings with single line or strings with multiple lines. Similar to other languages, Python also allows us to have strings with escape sequences. So consider this statement, Python slash n program. Here you can see this special symbol slash n, which indicates the escape sequence. It has some special meaning. When that symbol is executed, then how Python displays that string is Python in a separate line and programming in the other line. The reason is here slash n indicates a new line symbol that indicates whatever follows will be displayed in the next line. That's how the same string is displayed in two different lines. That's how we can use escape sequences with strings. But here I want to display slash n also as part of my string. Then I want to treat that as a raw string. How raw strings can be indicated in Python is whichever strings that are prepended with the symbol R, they are treated as raw string, and whatever you enclose within that strings that are followed by R, they are treated as raw string. So consider this example here. I am using the escape sequence slash n and I am prepending the symbol R. So in that case, what happens is if you execute that including the escape sequence, that string will be displayed as it is. That slash n will not be treated as escape sequence because you are treating that string as a raw string. So whatever you are placing, enclosing within that quotes, that will be displayed as it is. Now try to understand the difference between the raw string and the normal string. So when you are using some special symbols like escape sequences, so if it is a normal string, then it has the effect of escape sequences. But when you are using the raw string, so the strings are prepended by R, so the string will be treated whatever you are enclosing as it is displayed as it is. Now let's see how we can use Unicode string literals. So Python supports non-English and special characters also as part of the string literals, and Unicode characters are used to represent the individual characters of the string, and these Unicode characters can be printed by prepending U with the string. So consider this example. Here we are prepending the string with the symbol U. Then when you execute this statement, whatever is the Unicode character is available that is indicated with slash u, that will be treated as a Unicode character, and the character here indicates the tick mark, and the tick mark will be displayed. So consider this example, which contains multiple Unicode sequence of letters. So when I execute this, the output is a string of special symbols. That's how I can use strings with Unicode letters. So now let's see what are Boolean true value or a false value. So for example, I want to represent senior citizen. So senior citizen is true or false. So I'm assigning a true value to senior citizen, and male, I'm assigning that to false to indicate that it's a feminine. So what are special literals? So in addition to the numeric, string literals and Boolean literals, Python supports one special literal, that is none. So none indicates nothing, and that is also treated as a special literal in Python. Say for example, I'm assigning the none symbol to the variable a, which indicates that nothing. So in addition to all these types of literals, Python also supports collection literals. So which indicates that you can create a new literal by collecting all the other types of literals. And Python supports different types of literals like list collection literal, tuple collection literal, dictionary literal, and the set literal. So you can see the first example is a list. So we'll discuss all these details in the due course when we discuss the data structures. So far in this lecture, we have discussed what constants are, what literals are, what are the various types of literals that are supported by Python. So thereby we understand that what are the different values that can be assigned to variables or constants. So if it is a variable, it can be changed. If it is a constant, it cannot be changed. So Python offers different types of literals that can be assigned to either variables or constants. Like it offers numeric literals, string literals, even Boolean literals, and it offers a special type of literal like none. Even you can create a new collection literal by using the existing different types of literals. So now I hope you understand how you can use various types of literals in Python in your programming. Thank you for watching this video.